Hey, it's Earth Carson. Have you ever finished a long, tiresome mapping session, only to boot up your map and find out it's leaking? Well, today, I'll give you a tutorial on how to fix leaks and prevent them in the future. First, we must understand what leaks are. A leak is when there is a hole in your map, leading to the void outside. They usually look a little something like this, and are extremely bad for your map. If you have one, the shadows in your map will be much more dark than they should be, and the lighting will be messed up in all sorts of ways. One of the biggest signs of your map leaking will be the broken 3D skybox, if you are using a 3D skybox. If you have a leak in a 3D skybox, the skybox won't display at all, and if you look in certain directions, the whole sky goes black. Leaks also generally bring in a lot of problems with them. So, to fix these leaks, there's a very simple method that many new mappers may not have known. If you go up to the Map tab here and click on Load Point File, it will bring up this menu. If it brings up this menu, then you have no leaks. But if it brings up this menu, then you have leaks. Once you're on this menu, click Yes. This will draw a red line somewhere in your map. Generally, to find it, you can look at the 2D views, since it stands out, or just look for it in the 3D camera view. Once you've found it, follow the red line. If you don't find a leak on one of the ends, it's likely on the other end of the red line. This red line travels through your map, and through to where your leak is. Once you've found your leak, patch it up by covering it up with a brush. Once the leak has been sealed, there should be no more issues in your map. If you covered the leak and there's still issues, either you didn't cover it properly, or there are other issues in your map, or multiple leaks. Now that you know how to fix a leak, I'll tell you how you can prevent more leaks in the future. Now, this isn't going to magically make you never have leaks again, but it should help you if you have leaks in the future. The first thing you should do is stay on the same grid size, preferably 4 to 16, I'd say. If you stay on a medium-sized grid, you won't have any small, tiny, one-unit-wide holes that lead out into the void. So generally, you should stay on a medium-sized grid. The next tip is always to double-check around your map before compiling it. Sometimes, I forget to work on an area of my map, and right before I compile, I realized I left a huge leak in the floor. So, next time you've done some changes to your maps, make sure to double-check that there are no leaks. And that's pretty much it. I'm sure there's much more you can do to fix leaks, but I'm just using what I already know. I'm not a professional, but I've been mapping for a couple years now. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Like and subscribe and check out my other hammer-related content, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya!